So we said one of the biggest problems with k-means is that it was really sensitive to sort of needing to know how many clusters there were, what k was, and also possibly to the initial conditions that you gave it. So the assumption of k-means is that they're essentially these spherical clumps within feature space. So if you're thinking of these as a probability distribution, the idea is that there would be a couple of modes, peaks, in our feature space that and sort of falling nearby those peaks is a fall off, and that our pixel intensities are distributed according to a probability density function that has these modes. So if you could find the modes, you might be able to segment the image that way. So the approach that we're going to talk about for doing that is called the mean shift algorithm. And we actually introduced this when we were talking about tracking. It's a little bit easier to talk about that when we do it in as a clustering. So the mean shift algorithm was designed as a way of finding these modes or these local maxima of density in some feature space. So here, by the way, this is this beautiful pastel image of these houses and as the input image. And what we have here on the right is the plotting of each of these pixels in the LUV color space. Remember LUV color? This is why we're doing this whole conversation after we talked about color, because if I told you LUV and you hadn't heard it, you'd think I was doing RGB. No, it's LUV, right? And you can imagine right away that looking at a picture like this, the color, the chroma is what matters, and the absolute intensity might matter less, right? Because the, so let's see, using this yellow here, so this is a brighter yellow and this is a darker yellow, but I would like to have them both be in the same color segment. So LUV makes that easier.